All my life, I always try to be a good cook because music is a cooking.
And it's about sharing.
Sharing, of course, of course. And what we are doing right now, we are doing to leave something behind us to the other generations, to writing, to music. I'm trying to do this all my life. Music is a cooking. Cooking the souls. When you see somebody, it's crying. Tears is like salt in your music. You seeing somebody is laughing. That's pepper to use to your cooking. That's what I thought. That's what I feeling. Doesn't matter how many people in front of you. 5 people, 2,000 people, 5,000 people. But you have to get 2 eyes and looking at you and listening you. Bottom of heart. Just I'm looking this when I play. Doesn't matter where I play, because I start the music with my father. My father is a wood player, like Ardinchan. I'm start the music with the wedding party in the street. Doesn't matter where you are play music, Carnegie Hall, on the street. Actually, sometimes the street is better. People more natural. In the street, people more naked. Are there, right there. Just bottom of heart, they dancing, they singing. I think that's the idea about the music in my mind. So I'm trying to cooking. Right now I'm 55. I'm start 8 years old with violin. My first instrument is a violin. Actually, my father wants me to play violin. But somehow I couldn't have a relationship with violin when I was, 8 years old. I don't know, you try violin in your life to play? Never. So it's a hard instrument, world hard instrument.
What kind of relationship were you looking for with your instrument?
Instrument is like your friend. To me it's like that. You not see some friends long time, and then you see you are hugging, you're crying. It's the same thing. My instrument sometimes is, I'm not touching. Usually I'm playing at the stage kanun, but violin it's, at home always. I play at home. Sometimes it's, maybe 1 month, 2 months, I couldn't play, I couldn't touch it. And I see over there, it's somebody's looking at me, says, "Hey, what happened?" I think it's this is the instruments and the person is relationship. You have to touch, you have to talk, and it's gonna answer you whatever you want.
To talk. Is it a
Talk.
conversation? What
Conversation.
kind of conversation is it?
Anything, any conversation, any conversation. You can ask, and it's gonna be answer you. So that's the then you're gonna be, start to playing, and that instrument is gives you the back to your, answers, what you're asking, what you're saying. So then maybe next morning, and you're gonna start to playing this song.
But you're a multi-instrumentalist. How is
Yes.
it possible to play well a lot of different instruments?
Actually, I cannot say it's well, very well, because I'm not saying the young persons to play 3, 4 instruments. If you're gonna play the instrument, you should play one instrument to be perfect.
What is your favorite instrument? What is the instrument that
Well,
resonates the most with you?
I like to play percussion also. I'm percussions also. Actually, I'm start when I child when I was work with my father. There's a one orchestra. It's a nightclub. There's a one orchestra. They play everything whole night, maybe 6, 7 hours. Mostly drummers, only one drummer play all the time. The other bands is changed, but drummer never changed. He plays the drum set, he plays the, Turkish, the darbuka. And they said, "Hasan, you should learn a little bit the drum. I said, why? I understand he needs help, you know. So I start to learn drum and to help him. So mostly in the night, I'll help the drum players, maybe 1 hour, 2 hours. So I start to learn the drum also. Now I had a relationship. I cannot get out this, you know, right now I'm playing the rhythm, violin, kanun. But like I said, the young guys, don't try this. You want to be drummer, just, you know, play the drum. Don't confuse yourself if you're going to be perfect. But to me now, yes, I'm a percussionist, I'm violin player, I'm kanun player, and try to cooking music.
How do you prepare yourself before performing on stage?
Actually, I don't do anything. I'm ready. I can go on stage anytime, no problem. If be myself and my orchestra, I don't need the repertoire. Depends on what we're going to play, but I don't need the repertoire. I had on my mind what I'm going to play. But there is a different people to we're going to play. Okay, we have to do rehearse. But in my orchestra, if we know each other, like Aradin Chion, we play maybe 25 years together. Now we're going to go on stage, we can play 5 hours without no rehearse.
So playing is like just being for you.
That's it. Very simple.
What kind of feeling are you looking for yourself when you're performing on stage?
I never think about it. Because when I grow up in the music, in my father and my father's friends, I learned like this. Guys, 5 minutes, we are on the stage. Okay? Maybe there's a special singer. So I was the youngest one. So they said, Hasan, and go to ask what she's going to be sing. Like, okay. So I go and I said, ma'am, what would you like to singing tonight? And she said, okay, about this, you know, Turkish music we call makam, it's a mod, you know, says, okay, this makam in A major or A minor. So, okay, we go on stage, we start to playing, and she's come out and she's singing 2 hours and no asking nothing. So if you've grown up like this, when you go on stage, feeling about the exciting, yes, I'm exciting, but I'm not worried anything. I'm always ready to play.
So the conversation you have with the audience is like an emotional conversation.
Yes, so that's the most important part you're asking now. When you play in your instrument, if you're just gonna play, people gonna clapping you, you know. But if you put your heart and your soul in your mind all together, you can make the people cry over there.
But what does it require from you to put your soul in your music?
This is natural from the God. You cannot learn this. Any school in the world, Berkeley or in New York, wherever it's the best schools, they teach you how you play, how you sing, but they cannot teach, put your heart in your instrument, put your heart in your finger, put your heart in your voice. No, this is special from God, to gift. That's why there's a million musicians, but not everybody have that special thing to him.
Did you ever experience an audience that didn't resonate with your music?
I wish you come and see me one day.
I saw you at Carnegie Hall.
Maybe some other places. Not, you know, like a Carnegie Hall, like a regular, you know, maybe a restaurant. You know, remote is in your hand. If you know what you're going to do, you can change to that bad audience to be a good audience. When you go stage, you cannot play in your head, is in your, you know, instrument like this. You have to look at the audience. You have to see the audience, because people is coming outside whole day, they tired, you know, they couldn't get the, you know, that feeling right there. So you have to change that.
And you can transform it.
Yes, exactly. We are the transformers. We are the transformers.
What do you need to start composing a piece of music?
There is not a, such a thing like that. Okay, you say, oh, all right, I'm starting to writing song. No, there is no such a thing like that. I think right time, it's coming, songs is there. But first, something, it's gonna be touch your heart, touch your soul. It's happen anywhere, anytime. On the street, you see maybe some cats, some dogs, or some people on the street. Or you see some people happy or sad, but you have to be touching yourself. Maybe you not understand that time, what happened to you, but next few days, next 3 days, maybe next 5 days, you get your instrument and you start to play. That's happened to me like this. And sometimes in my dreams, I had a lot of, you know, melodies and get up and play. So many times I get up and I play the melodies. But you cannot do that, like say, okay, right now, yeah, I gotta write in the song. Yeah, you can write it the song, but it's not gonna be song. Like, you know, right now all over the world is like a pop music. Maybe it's gonna be 2 months, 3 months. Oh, it's a very famous song. And after 3 months, nobody remember the song. Like fast food.
You said the song is already in my mind. What do you mean?
You know, when it comes to in your heart, so it's heart is relationship in your head. So when it comes to your heart, your mind is already got it, the song. So then you can play. That's simple, very simple. But you have to get it first. I think it, to me, the melodies is right up there in the sky. Like people say, I have a song in the air. There's a lot of songs, a lot of melodies in the air. Air is recording everything. So you're catching something and you play. But you need something to touch in your heart.
As a composer, which traditions influence you the most?
It's not only tradition, but I learn the music, of course, Turkish classical music. That's the tradition you have to know. Any kind of musicians in the world, you have to know your classical music first. If you don't know your classical music, then you cannot influence the others. I wasn't going to university conservatory, but I learned the music. My father and my father friends, where they are very special musicians. So I learned the instruments and I learned how to write the music, how to read the music. So to me, it's the best conservatory I had, you know. And of course, stage, that's the another conservatory. You learn music and you play same time. When I came to United States, I worked with other musicians, of course, you know, jazz players, some other music. You listen every day, different music. Now I do my music. It's like jazz, and Turkish classical, Turkish folk. You can hear everything together. This is the world cooking. World music, it's world cooking. We have all together. We have jazz guitar, jazz piano, and we have Turkish zurna, ney, everything. It's mixed right now.
About this mixed music, about world music, does world music mean a loss of cultural identity, traditions for you?
No, definitely not. If you know your tradition, how are you gonna lose? Because you know your tradition. So you're sharing some other culture and they learn your music, your tradition. No, it's growing up. Of course, it's getting bigger. Because when I give you my culture, you learn my culture. And you teach somebody else my culture. So it's growing up. When you share, it's growing up. So we're not losing anything. We're sharing and we're growing up together. I hope one day the other people to understand this, to, you know, sharing is growing up. Sharing is learn to be a human being, actually. When you listen music, maybe 5 minutes, maybe 2 minutes, you're forgetting everything. That's the pure human being. You're right there. Maybe 5 minutes. You're forgetting what the, you know, society is trying to make you. This is the you are. No. When you go there and you listen to music, 5 minutes, you are a human being right there.
There's something universal.
That's universal, definitely.
Do you need silence?
All the noise is up there, not inside you. You know, you can be silenced in your heart.
I'm going to leave the space. Please hold the microphone and add whatever you want to the interview.
Okay, guys. This is my first interview. I got to say the young persons who they are trying to be a musician, trying to be a composer. There's three things you have to do. One is a dreaming, and second is work for that dream. And third, you never forget your dream. Make that dream every day refresh, and you'll be there wherever you want then. Thank you.
I am done.